back to our show. You know, as we enter December, a lot of people are thinking about how much money they're going to have to spend or how much money they're going to have to borrow in order to fill all those Christmas and Hanukkah and Kwanzaa and all the other orders that come around this time of year. Kim Miller joins us, certified financial planner with Sweetwater Investments, who held senior positions in several capacities at other firms before joining Sweetwater. Well, Kim, how you doing, my man?
Well, I'm doing great. It's the holiday season. Let's spend some money.
Yeah, let's...
Yes.
All right. Spend it right over here, baby.
That's right.
So this is really interesting. In fact, you just told us, or told me before, while we were off the air, about what's going on in consumer spending and consumer confidence. Why don't you dig into that a little bit, buddy?
Well, consumer confidence is up. Why does that report come out on Black Friday? Why? You can guess. It's so people will go spend money. It's you, the individual, against the marketing machine. Everything that goes on in the retail business and the internet now is designed to separate you from your money. You got the wallet with the money in it. They want their piece of it. They want the biggest possible piece they can get. So how many listeners out there are still paying off last year's Christmas bills?
Probably a lot.
There's a few of them. Consumer spending on Christmas is up. It's back to pre-recession levels this year. It's going to be $854 on average. That hasn't
been... Per person?
Per family or unit.
Spending. Household? You know,
household, yeah. So that hasn't been that high since 2007.
Wow.
And in 2009, which was the nadir or the low, it was $417. So it's doubled from the low. So that's a lot of money. And how many people out there have put away that $854 in cash so they can go out and spend it? Not very many.
Right.
They're going to put it on their credit card. Humans are great at rationalization. Oh, I can pay it off with my bonus. I'll pay it off next summer. I'll get it paid off by next Christmas. BS. It ain't going to happen. It ain't going to happen. You're going to be looking at your credit card bill, and your credit limit is down to $39. And you're going to be working on, you're going to be trying to work that off for the next 10 years. It's crazy.
Yeah.
So you have to fight back. You have to rein it in.
And be really conscious about it, it would seem. Because, you know, you talked about the individual versus the marketing machine. And it's kind of funny because every commercial is kind of trying to get your money. You have the
exactly.
ones who are trying to
yeah.
sell you stuff.
Yeah.
But then you have the investment firms that are also trying to get your money to invest it. One way or another. That's the goal, right? So you kind of, you know, you go, you watch the guy who retires, and like, oh, I should save my money. And then the next ad is for a new car. Like, oh, I need a new car.
Right.
And, you know, it's you got every 30 seconds, you're getting hit with a new message.
That's right. They want to, you put the money away in the 401k plan and so you can take it out and buy a new car next year.
Right.
Okay, well, you won't be successful if you do that.
Yeah.
Because you'll have spent the money twice.
So how does somebody, and I actually want to get into this Whole Foods conversation too, and the way they are trying to dig into people's wallets, but how do you recommend people, how do you manage the marketing machine that's out there?
Well, it's not
for
easy.
Yourself, I guess.
Well, for me, I just don't shop. I don't go out. I don't do it. I have a pretty short list. I've only got three kids. One of them lives in Europe, so I don't want to spend a lot of money on that because it cost me more to ship it over there than what I bought.
There you go.
You know, so
Amazon gift certificates.
Yeah, and that's another thing. Don't buy gift cards. If that's a one-size-fits-all solution. A very high percentage of those never get cashed out. Guess who makes money on that? The bank, the retailer, because they got your money.
Right.
Because people just don't, oh, that's great, and I'll go down and spend it, and then they don't. It just goes in the back of the drawer, and you find it when grandma dies. There's four or five gift cards sitting there with $600 on them. Never got used.
Yeah.
So the thing is, you have to, you know, this is timeless advice. You set a budget. I'm only going to spend X on each person that I have to buy for. And you talked earlier about drawing names or, you know, just cutting down the number of gifts you have to buy so you can do a little higher quality on each one. That's fine. But know what you're going to spend. Another way to do that is only go out with cash. Leave all of your cards, including your debit card, at home.
Oh, but Kim, then I won't get the points.
That's right.
Or the miles.
You
I don't spend money, Kim. I get miles.
You pay for those miles. Believe me. It's all part of the machine. if we can get you to spend money because we promise you free airline miles, you're going to spend more money than you otherwise would have. So if you can manage that, great. You pay that off every time. That's great. But most people don't do that.
Well, and the other thing now is I know with what I personally, a Bank of America will actually give you an Alaska Airlines card on your debit card.
Right. Get like 50 cents for every dollar.
I get like one millionth of a flight at 3 o'clock in the morning on a Tuesday.
Right.
If I can ever get anywhere.
Right. Yeah. And you pay $35 a year for that.
Yeah, that's true.
Just for that part of it.
Yeah.
Plus, you're more likely to spend the money because you think it's free. Of course, it's not free. It's all priced in.
Right.
If you've ever gotten credit card offers in the mail, and everybody does, they all have different little features that are designed to get you to
some
bite
people
on
want
that.
The cash back. Some people want the airline miles.
Exactly.
Some people want the TV. Some
exactly.
people want the...
And it's all priced in. It's priced into the interest rate. It's priced into the fee you pay. It's priced into what the merchant pays.
They're not in the business of just giving away free stuff?
No. They're in the business of getting into your wallet.
Yeah.
That's the whole point right there.
Well, let's and we're here with Kim Miller with Sweetwater Investments. Kim, let's go into another place that people maybe don't recognize they're going into their wallet because, as you said, everybody can rationalize buying food, right? You're buying mm-hmm. food for the family. You got to eat. At
sure.
least I'm not going
eat.
Out to dinner.
Yeah.
Let's talk a little bit about this new thing that's going on at the grocery stores.
Well, the marketing machine is in evidence there, too, just like it is anywhere else. You've probably all shopped at a locally headquartered discount warehouse club. They have the huge carts. They only have one size cart, right?
No, they also have flatbeds.
And they have the flatbeds. Yeah. So when you buy the three TVs, you got something to haul, and the sofa, you have
right.
something to haul it out on. That's right. But so it's designed to get you to maximize what you put in there. I went to their annual meeting one year, and the recently retired CEO answered a question from the audience. The question was, when are you going to put in a 10-item limit line? And he goes, 10 items? Hell, it'll be 100 minimum. You know, so they're not into that business. They're into share of wallet, right?
Sure.
By the way, they just announced today they're paying out a $7 special dividend before the end of the year. So if you own the stock by the record date, you'll get an extra $7.
That's
a little
good.
Tip. So anyway.
So it seems to me that, now there's other grocery stores that are actually doing this, and they're actually... Mm-hmm. Kind of, we'll just call it Costco. We'll call it what it is.
Sure.
But, they are taking this bigger shopping cart
yes.
idea and installing it in their stores.
Yes. Whole Foods, for example.
Mm-hmm. Which isn't expensive enough, right?
Which is a food circus. That's what it is. It's a food circus. You walk in there, you see the colors are designed to attract your attention. You see those crates that they have, you know, that look like they're all beat up and stuff. Well, maybe they did actually use those, but those are strategically placed to get your attention and to make you feel good about it.
Like they're like it's right off the truck.
Exactly. Exactly. And the music they play, they target their audience with the tunes they put over the pipe in. So who's the target audience at Whole Foods? Probably your boomers and your older Gen X or millennials. Okay, they're going to target the hits those people grew up with to bring in a comfort level for them. And, of course, in the background of there, the real science of that is there's probably some subliminal stuff that says, buy more.
Buy
right.
more.
That's a
buy
time,
more.
That's a time-honored deal. It's like commercials, you know, where they cut in stuff that you don't see, but your subconscious catches up to it. But one of the games that they're playing is they made their shopping carts just a little bit bigger because they studied it and they found that bigger shopping carts led to as much as a 40% increase in purchases.
And that doesn't, and people probably aren't eating 40% more food.
No. I don't know what the percentage is, but a very high percentage of food in this country
goes to waste.
Goes in the trash.
Yeah.
Because people buy too much. They can't eat it fast enough.
You know, the other side of that is if you go to other grocery stores, they got the little carts now.
Yes,
which I think are actually the upgrade from the hand basket. So
right.
now it's like, well, we'll get rid of the hand baskets, which are a pain anyways to carry around.
Yeah, because put the milk in there. They're not ergonomically designed.
No, they're horrible.
Makes your arm hurt to carry it.
Yeah,
you put the milk in there, and all of a sudden
it's all cockeyed, yeah, and you know, it makes it tough.
Right. So you get the little cart.
You got to get two milks just to balance it out, right?
Right.
So you get the little cart, and then they give you two baskets.
Right. So you're going to spend more.
Right.
And it feels more convenient to you because well, I can just wheel my little cart along. I'm not lugging the, sure, the basket, you know. So, exactly.
So, Kim, we just have about a minute left before we have to go to break. But the so when you start going in, when you recognize these things, when you recognize the cart is bigger, you recognize the commercials you watch are going to try to sell you things. You recognize, you know, if you're listening to the radio, the commercials are probably trying to sell you things. Is that that first kind of step in, I guess, Spenders Anonymous? You got to understand all the angles it's coming at you from, so you, I guess you can deflect them.
Right. If you know what they're doing, and it's pretty easy to figure that out. I mean, we live in America. America probably has the most intense advertising campaigns in the entire world.
I've heard people are see something like 3,000 advertisements per day.
Yeah, exactly. So play the game. Don't play the game. Just recognize that everybody wants a piece of your wallet and decide what you need versus what you want versus what you desire, because those are all three different things. So fill the needs first and then work on the other things.
Yeah, well, Kim, always a pleasure. Stick around for a few minutes. We got maybe a song that we might bring back here at the end of the show.
All right.
Kim Miller with Sweetwater Investments. When we come back, Ryan Leopold will join us from Cobalt Mortgage. We'll be back right after this break.